With Windows 10, Microsoft gave us the Snipping Tool, and then not too soon after, replaced it with Snip and Sketch. Now, with Windows 11, Microsoft has returned us to the Snipping Tool again. But what's different, and how can you use it? Let's look at it in this video. Hi, I'm Michelle, a computer coach, here sharing tips and tricks on your everyday software to make life that little bit easier. Most people who view my videos aren't subscribed. If that's you, then please do click that subscribe button down below and press the notification bell to be told as new videos come out. Let's get on with today's video. As you'd expect, in the search or the Windows Start, simply start typing in Snip. I've been using it quite frequently, so it's already on my list, and just click on the Snipping Tool. We get a similar window that we used to have, but the key difference between the old snipping tool and our brand new one is the fact that not only do we have the ability for static images, but we've now got the ability to record our screen as well. Let's take a quick look at the recording. This isn't going to be perfect because I'm recording my screen already, but with record, all we do is flick it across to record. And you'll notice we don't have any other options. So let's click New. That's now giving me the message that I need to create the area that I want. So I am going to click and drag and just grab a big bit of my screen. And now I've got the message to start recording. Because I have got the audio recording in this video, it's not letting me record my microphone or record the system audio, which is absolutely fine. Now I'm done. I just simply click start recording and I get the countdown. And now this is recording. I can move around, see what I've got, perform my commands as normal. And when I'm done, I can simply pause it or I can stop recording however I want. The other key difference is that I can actually edit in ClipChamp, which is Microsoft's basic video editing. To find it, if I close that down, which I'll get back up in a minute, it's actually under Videos, Screen Recordings, and there you can see it's there underneath today's date. I can now watch that, edit it, do whatever I want with it, delete it, etc. That's all there for me. So let me get rid of that and go back into the snipping tool. And let's have a look at what the snipping tool was always for, which was grabbing snips of the desktop. Switch it back to be the image with the camera icon, and I've now got all of my options available. What's slightly different from Snip and Sketch? The biggest difference in terms of an image is that the new button is now just a button. It doesn't do anything else. The delay, which we liked in there, has now been separated out again. But we do also have a third delay time. So we've got 3, 5, and 10 seconds as options. Simply choose the one that you want. You can see the number is displayed by the little alarm clock. And I can click New. What that's going to do is let me perform whatever commands I want. And then after the set period of time, then freeze the screen and let me see whatever I need. The button before it, the mode, is actually our standard commands. So rectangle to click and drag and draw an area, window. Now, please note, window actually means not only a window as in the application, but it can also mean the window for an option. So if you've got a dialog box up, it can mean just the dialog box. Just move to find out what you're actually about to select before you click. Full screen is the whole screen. And of course, if you've got one monitor, that's never a problem. If you've got multiple monitors, that can include both of them. You're able to then crop it down if you just want one, but bear in mind that that's something that can happen. Freeform is that I can click and create a shape of whatever I want. I don't actually need to choose that first if I don't want to, because as soon as I click New, I'm just going to start up. Let's pull something up. and switch back to my snipping tool. So if I now click new, and don't forget I've got delay on, so that's why it's waiting. Okay, it's got my default, which is the rectangle, but the reason it doesn't matter is because I can change it here if I want. So if I want the whole window, I can simply click there and get that window. It does appear to be quite small, but don't forget it's a standard window, so you can always resize it to have a look at the different options. From here, let's just minimize that down, maximize that out. From here, I can retake it with any of my commands again. Over here on the far right-hand side, I've now got edit in paint. So again, that's slightly new, equivalent to the edit in ClipChamp. Paint, of course, is Microsoft's built-in image editing application. It should automatically be copying it. So if I just want to paste it into somewhere else, it's fine. And of course, I can save it. And the default location is pictures, underneath your main account. Similar to the Snip and Sketch application, I've now got access to tools. I've still got the pen where I can draw things, highlighter, and of course I can click on any of these to change the thickness and the colours from one that it gives me. I've got the eraser, which will erase the item that I click on. One of the things I really like is the new shapes. And what this does is it allows me to draw certain things on it. My preference is that I don't have a fill color. I do have an outline, but I like the red one. And now when I select the shapes, I can actually click and drag like I do in the main applications, the main Microsoft applications, and draw the shape. This to me is so much easier rather than me having to try and draw a very bad rectangle. Or an oval, so I can change to whatever I want, which is what I've normally done through my handouts and my guides to highlight things. So I really appreciate this. Then I have got my crop facility, but this is the new one, the text actions. When I click on there, it actually will select things and it says, do I copy the text? Which means that it's grabbing the text out of the picture for me and I can go and paste that somewhere else. I can copy it as a table and I can quickly redact things. It's going to redact email addresses and phone numbers as standard. So that new text actions is something that I think actually could be really useful. I just clicked on the button to close it. And of course, I have got undo and redo exactly as I'd expect. Let's take that back down to a window. What is one of the downsides? Well, if you're anything like me and you need to take screenshots to show somebody how to do something, the biggest problem that I've come across is that I can no longer take right clicks. So, for example, I can, of course, expand menus out and take the screenshot. However, it will not let me put the delay on, perform a right click, and then take that screenshot. It no longer sort of freezes the screen. I'll show you. So, if I go into anything, if I now put my delay back on, I'm going to do 5 seconds, click new. Let me right click. There's my right click command. Let's wait this, and you'll see that the second that the delay is finished, it hasn't grabbed anything. It doesn't let me do anything. So sadly, I can no longer use the snipping tool for certain commands. However, overall, I found that the new snipping option has a couple of really useful features that I am certainly going to make good use of. If you like this video, please do give it a thumbs up. It really does help the channel. And I will see you on the next video.